everyone! It's me, the Otaku Fangirl, here to review episode 8 of Junji Ito Collection, or Ito Junji Collection, whatever you want to call it. So with this episode, well, the first story was not bad. It was pretty interesting, a little disturbing, but the second one was boring as all heck. But anyway, with the first one, though, we have this, girl named Risa who has lost her memories, and one night a disturbing caterpillar shows up in her room, and I really don't understand the whole caterpillar thing. I don't know if it was alluding to the whole thing later, but it was weird. I'm like, what's with the caterpillar? I thought the whole caterpillar would be the... But I guess you could say it was kind of alluding to the stuff that happens later, but eh. So, she has this guy she apparently was engaged to named Shuichi. I was reminded of Shuichi from Danganronpa V3, and they're like, I'm like, his name's Shuichi! But anyway, so yeah, it's like, I can never forget his name now, but anyway. So... Basically, they've been engaged, and she can't remember it because she has amnesia, and we don't really know why she does. I thought, oh, maybe it's the caterpillar. Maybe the caterpillar's doing something creepy to her. No, it just, that was, I don't know why the caterpillar was there. I guess it's because later on we learned that, well, Shuichi's father is dying, and when he entered the room, he entered in a very weird way. We never saw the top of his head, and I'm like, there's probably something attached to his head that's controlling him, or... something, right? And I was kind of right, because later on, the dad's, like, dying, basically, and, you know, Shuichi's like, ah, Risa, I need you to come, quick, dad needs you, and she's like, what? And so she goes and finds out, well, that attached to his head is the head of all of their ancestors, basically forming a kind of caterpillar kind of thing. So I'm thinking, okay, so I guess that's why the caterpillar would appear in her dream. I don't know. But, yeah, that was kind of disturbing. I'm like, oh, and they can still kind of, like, they can hear the thoughts of, like, all the ancestors and everything, proved by when the dad does die, Shuichi gets all the heads on his head, and, you know, he needs to marry Risa and have a kid with her so the bloodline's, you know, safe and everything, and they can continue the whole keeping the brains of the ancestors alive, and it's just disturbing. And I guess she just kind of fell into the trap because she just kind of collapsed on the side of the wall, and she was like, and I'm like, okay, so I guess, that's a thing. I'm just like, well then, yup. So, with the second story though, we have this circus coming to town, and well, basically it's just a killer circus, as the ringmasters, apparently, according to Lady Lelia, whatever her name was, some kind of demon, or the Reaper trying to take souls and stuff. I don't know if any of that's true, or if she's just saying that to be like, oh, he likes to kill people, you know, I don't know. And so, throughout all the circus acts, everybody starts dying, except for her, because she's like the grand prize, if you can pull off all your acts and stuff. And apparently all these people are not even like trained circus people, they're just people from the audience, because later on when they're all dead, he's like, would any of you like to join our circus, and blah blah blah, and I'm just like, okay. And I'm guessing the guy in the hat who was kind of the protagonist of that little story joined because he wanted to marry the lady, Lelia, or whatever her name was, and I'm just like, that was boring, but okay. I don't know, that one was just really boring, because I'm just like, I don't care about these people dying. There's no... Like, sure, he could be a demon, the ringmaster. Sure, he could just be a normal psychopath. One or the other, you know. But most likely could be a demon wanting to just take souls for reasons. I don't know. And I'm just like, I don't care either. But first story wasn't bad. Second story, meh. Was eh. Not even that good. So, yeah. But what'd you guys think of this episode? What do you think's gonna happen next? And I'll see you guys in whatever I view next. Bye!